One of our goals with the E.A.R podcast is to be committed to God's command in Matthew 28:19. We strive to take the gospel to all nations and to engage the unreached and to support our brothers and sisters on the mission field. I am asking that you join me in supporting my buddy Timothy Rodrigue with his upcoming missions work in July of 2020. Here's what he has to say.
Hey guys, it's Tim. I'm making this video to reach out and ask for your support in a cause that's dear to my heart. This coming July, I am going on a mission trip to the Dominican Republic. While there, my church family and I will build churches, share God's love, and simply just give our friendship and hospitality. I can't afford the cost all by myself. If you could please pray about donating, I could really use the help, and I appreciate anything I receive. You could donate to my Venmo account, which is @Timothy-Rodrigue, or to my Facebook account, Timothy Rodrigue. I trust God will get me there through your donations. Thank you, and God bless.
If you haven't heard about Anchor, it is the easiest way to make a podcast. Please, let me explain. One, it is free. Two, there's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from the phone or computer. Anchor will distribute your podcast for you so it could be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many, many others. You can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It is everything you need to make a podcast in one place. So please, download the free Anchor app and go to anchor.fm and get started today.
The E.A.R. Evangelical and Reformed Christian Podcast. Welcome to The E.A.R., the Evangelical and Reformed, a Christian podcast that urges you to think deeper and draws you closer to God through faith. Through powerful sermons, teaching segments, and discussions, The E.A.R. hopes to give you a different perspective on secular topics from a Christian worldview. He who has ears to hear, let him hear. Please welcome your host, Brandon Queen.
And that's been a real joy for me to serve in places that themselves are relatively unknown.
Is it okay to be unknown so that Christ can be known? Yes, of course it is. The E.A.R. podcast presents to you a brand new season, season 5, entitled Unknown with Reverend Dr. Matthew Everhard. This podcast series is being made for the ordinary Christians who can have an extraordinary influence.
The value of the human soul is equal, whether you have the opportunity to minister in a large congregation.
We often seek the fame of notoriety and being known by the masses. The goal is for Christ to be known to many, and we are the tools God uses through His Word to redeem souls for His glory alone. There is an underlying issue that we all face, and we all can admit that we, as Matthew called it, can be humbly bragging. And we can often miss the opportunity to really share the gospel with lost people.
Welcome back, Podcast World, to another episode of The E.A.R. Today, we start a brand new season titled Unknown, and it is written by the Matthew Everhard. What's up, Matt?
Hey, Brandon. Good to be back on the show. How are you, sir?
I am well, and it is awesome because you get a whole season to yourself. A whole
season. I know. I like it that way. I'm very selfish.
Titled Unknown.
Yeah, I know. The irony of it all, right?
Well, if you'll allow me, I want to let the audience know who you are.
Okay.
So Matt and I, we've been friends for about 4 to 5 years now. We met each other back in 2017-ish at a general assembly for the Evangelical Presbyterian Church. And at the time, Matt was the pastor of the Evangelical Presbyterian Church in Orlando, Florida. Am I right?
It was Brooksville. Yeah, Brooksville, a suburb of Orlando, I guess, broadly speaking.
Gotcha. So since then, Matthew has moved on to the Gospel Fellowship, our Presbyterian Church in America, which is our sister denomination. During all that time, Matt has written several books, A Theology of Joy, a study on Jonathan Edwards and the external happiness in the Holy Trinity. He also did another book on a collection of essays on Jonathan Edwards. And he also wrote a book called Hold Fast the Faith, a doctrinal commentary on the Westminster Confession of Faith of 1647. And now today, we're talking about a brand new book that just recently published called Unknown. So tell us, what made you write this book?
Well, actually, this is the second edition of a book that I had written a while back. When I wrote it a few years ago, it actually goes back to 2013. I really only did it for one little purpose, and that was as a devotional guide for a mission trip that we were going on back when I was the pastor of Faith Church in Brooksville, Florida. And so it was really just intended for that trip. I think there was maybe 8 or 10 people on the trip, and I wrote a devotional just for that experience. And a little bit later, well, recently, I was going back through some of that material, and I thought to myself how incredibly relevant, and even more so than it was back in 2013, if that's even possible, is the idea that we who are Christians serve our great and living God very often in ways that are unrecognized and unrewarded and in a fair bit of anonymity. At least as the world goes. And I thought, man, I really need to get this thing out and polish it up. I'm going to update a bunch of its illustrations and its stories, and I'm going to get this thing ready to release again in a second edition, which will be a little bit better, a little bit more updated, and a little bit more contemporary.
All right. Now, I was privileged. Well, I seem like a privileged kid now. I was privileged to get a copy of this book before it went to the press. And as I was sitting down looking over what I've already read, I am not the best person to do a book review because I write all over the book. But I have to say, I only read the dedication once, and then I read chapter 1 and 2 twice. But the dedication, I went back to it this morning before our interview, Matt. And I love the fact that you point out this one. I'm going to read this one little paragraph to you, and I want you to kind of expound on it some more. But the paragraph says this: none of us are great. None of us are famous. None of us are anything more than redeemed sinners, saved by grace. Yet, I love that word, yet, since Christ knew us by name before the foundation of the world, indeed elected us for salvation, we are known to the one who matters the most. Matt, that is a very beautiful paragraph. Like, it's
yeah. Thank
beautiful.
You, brother.
And when I was reading it, I'm sitting there and I'm like, oh my gosh, like I'm coming out of my chair reading this. And I'm like, that's it. We're nothing more than just redeemed sinners. Our fame does not save us. Our fame doesn't, you know, get us out there to sell the gospel. God doesn't give us fame, if you will, to brag about ourselves. You know, like, let's focus on being unknown, however, still sharing the gospel with the lost people. You know?
Yeah, that's exactly it. And that paragraph is in the context of the dedication in which I'm dedicating the book essentially to the two Presbyterian churches that I've served as the pastor, Brooksville at Faith Church in Brooksville, Florida, and now here at Gospel Fellowship in Valencia, PA. And what's interesting about both of these two churches that I love, and you know, I served Faith Church for about 11 years, and Gospel Fellowship for here just for a couple of months. But one thing that they both have in common is that they're both near big cities, with Faith being close to both Tampa and Orlando, and Gospel Fellowship being up here closer to Pittsburgh. But both of the cities in which the churches are found are just regular old small town little places. They wouldn't necessarily show up on any map. If you were to look at, an old-fashioned print map, of course, we all use Google Maps now, but if you found any old regular map, those cities would not show up. They would be close to the big cities, but they would not have a place on the map. They're not the kind of place, either Brooksville or Valencia, that you can talk about with people from out of state because nobody's ever heard of them. Only locals would know these small towns, and that's been a real joy for me to serve in places that themselves are relatively unknown. And so, we don't have any. There's no famous members of either one of these churches. There's nobody who CNN is tracking, or nobody who has a Twitter account with 10,000 followers or anything like that. It's just a bunch of regular old people like us.
Yeah, that's awesome, man. So one of the things that I like is, and I say this often, I would love to see someone from a small town make it, if you will. And I'm not saying that because, 9 out of 10 we're unknown and we're not on maps or anything, but that would show America, or the world, if you will. Let's rephrase that. That would show the world that it doesn't matter what small town you come from and how unknown it is, God's word is still going to go forth.
Yeah, that's right, man. And ordinary people can do amazing things, even if they don't make it, because, as I'm saying in that one paragraph that you quoted, we are known, but it's to the Father. He is the one who has known us and even loved us before the foundation of the world. He knew our names. He knew how many days we would live. He knew who we would marry, if anybody. He knew everything about us even before he made the world. And so even if we never get our name in the newspaper, or we never have a video that gets 100,000 views, or if we never have a tweet that's retweeted 20,000 times, we're known to the Father, and he keeps careful watch over all of us. He loves us dearly. And at the end of the day, it really doesn't matter whether or not the world ever puts our name up in lights.
Hey, you're right about that. Now, I'll admit, I have been in our local newspaper several times on several different occasions. One, I was a freelance photographer for about 4 years. And I'm very active in Boy Scouts. So my name would often pop up in articles revolving around Boy Scouts because of my commitment at the time to the organization and all the stuff that I did with the organization. And then when I became a cop, my name showed up again because I met Kevin Costner. Okay, so you meet this famous person, if you will, but yet you have this unknown small town cop guy that gets a chance to meet this big wig, if you will. Mm-hmm. But what I will say is none of that matters to me. Yeah, it's great my name got in the paper. And I will say, so Thibodeau is unknown. Valencia is unknown. Brooksville, Florida is unknown. But the people we come in contact, are they known by the one that matters the most?
Yeah, that's exactly it. And he's the one whose name we are going about to publish to the world. I love the old King James Version has a line in the Gospels where it talks about that they went forth and published his name and made it known throughout the world. And I just love that phrase, to publish his name, because that's what we're doing, is we're preaching about the gospel of the one who really does matter. There is a name that should be known to all peoples, and that name is Jesus Christ. And in that sense, it doesn't matter, whether the person who's speaking that name is himself known or treasured or loved by many, because even the most anonymous Christian can faithfully proclaim the goodness of Christ and his redeeming love to the world.
Right. Now, I want to point out a grammatical error in your book.
Okay. All right.
I'm joking when I say grammatical error, but I'm going to prove a point here. So the very last line, it says, we are known to the one who matters the most. And you got one capitalized.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, if you're not a quote-unquote believer, or you're not a Christian, but you're listening to this podcast, or if you come across the book and you're listening to it, one is capitalized because it's referring to God the Father. Am I correct?